Hello friends, I am Samitinja Bensode from JSPM and TSSL Group of Institute, Nare, Pune. So today we are going to do the net experiment of the California bearing ratio test. This test is basically performed on the subgrade soil. So subgrade soil is the very much important because depending on the subgrade soil, we have to give the different layers and we have to decide their thickness also. For the different types of the layer, as we know that there are two different types of the pavements, that is flexible pavement and another one is the rigid pavement. So in flexible pavement we are having the subbase course, base course, above the base course we are having the surface courses. So these courses, thickness of these courses, that will be decided with the help of California bearing ratio test. Again, for the rigid pavement, we are having the subbase course and the base course. For also these rigid pavements, we have to decide what kind of the thickness should be provided for the layers. So this test is basically performed on the subgrade soil. What we have to do, I will explain you about what we did before filling the mold. So this is the CBR mold. Before filling the CBR mold, what we have to do, we have to find out the OMC and MDD of the soil. So OMC and MDD, that will be found out from the Proctor's test. We can choose the modified Proctor's test or the standard Proctor's test. Depending on that, we will first find out the what is the optimum moisture content and what is the maximum dry density of the soil. After determining maximum dry density and the OMC, we have to fill this mold, CBR mold. CBR mold is different from the Proctor test. So we have to again fill this mold in 5 different layers with the help of 25 blows for each and every layer. And after application of 5 layers, we will just fill all the layers. CBR test that can be performed on the 2 different types of the samples. One is the soaked sample, another one is the unsoaked sample. So on unsoaked sample, if we need the quick results, so we can do the unsoaked sample test. And if we are having time to determine the soaked CBR, so we will go for the soaked CBR. Also, depending on the national highway, state highway, for national highway and state highway, we will do the soaked CBR test. For the village roads and for the other district road, we can perform the quick CBR also, that is the unsoaked CBR. So I have taken the unsoaked CBR sample here. Now we are going to apply the load on the sample and we will take the reading. So this is the loading frame that is used for the CBR test. And this is the probing ring. Here we are going to take the reading on the probing rings. And on this another extensometer, so we are going to measure the penetration of the plunger. This is called as the plunger. This plunger, it will be penetrated in the soil sample. And this is one disc which has been provided over the sample. This is nothing but the surcharge weight. As we know that our road that will be having some surcharge layers present on it, so on that account we have placed the surcharge weight above the so after that this soil, if we apply the load, what happens, the plunger that will be carried place and this assembly, whole assembly, that will goes in upward direction, and due to that the load that will come on this probing ring. And what is the penetration is there, that penetration we will record in this in this dial gauge. So we will perform the test. So I am going to apply the load on this. We can observe that there is a penetration in the penetration of the plunger that will be carried out. And here we can see the load is applied on the probing ring load. So now I am applying the load. We can observe that both the dial gauges, they are showing the reading. We have to take reading at 2.5 mm penetration and also the 5 mm penetration. But in meanwhile, the penetration we are going to take for the 0.5 mm penetration of the soil. So just we are going to apply the load. Okay, now we are having the observation table with us. So as per we perform the experiment on the CBR test, so we got the result as penetration for 0, so load we got 0. For 0.5 penetration, 0.5 mm penetration, we got the 5 kg load. So 1 17 1.5 29 2 42 2.5 50 3 88 then 4 78 5 92, 7.5 102 10 108 and 12.5 it is about 112 kg. So this is the penetration and these are the load corresponding that. But from the machine what we get, we got some reading for the load frame. So that reading multiplied by the constant of that probing ring, so we are getting the load. So this load is nothing but the test load, we are calling it as a test load. Now what we have to find out, we have to find out the CBR value. For finding CBR value, we have to take calculate the area plunger first, the plunger of diameter 5 cm. So I got the area plunger as 19.6, then the pressure on at 5 mm penetration, 2.5 mm penetration, so it is coming to be 2.959 kg per cm square. And for 5 mm penetration, it is coming to be about 4.123 kg per cm square. Now for finding out the CBR value at 2.5 mm penetration, we have to find out as test load divided by standard load, or test pressure divided by the standard pressure. So we are having the test pressure as 2.969 divided by the 70 as a test pressure. 70 as the standard pressure into 100, so we are getting result as here as a 4.2%. And for CBR value at 2.5 mm penetration, we are getting the result as 3.09%. It means that the CBR value at 2.5 mm penetration, it is greater than the CBR value at 5 mm penetration. So we got the good results. It means that our CBR value is of the 4.2%. This is our result, CBR value as a 4.2%. But condition, it may happen that sometimes the test value, that is CBR at 5 mm penetration, it comes more than the CBR at 2.5. So in that case, we have to do the same process on different same sample for 2 times. And if we get the result at 5 mm penetration, same result at the 5 mm penetration, then we have to take that CBR value of 5 mm penetration as a CBR value for the final results. So this value, if we are getting more at 5 mm penetration, then we have to repeat the test. And if we get the CBR value at 5 mm penetration less than the CBR value at 2.5 mm penetration, then in that case we are getting the result at 2.5 mm penetration. Now we have to plot the graph in between our penetration in mm and the load in kg. So this graph, it will be plotted after the taking the observation, because sometimes what happens that we are not getting the 0 point. So at 0 we are getting the curve, okay. So sometimes if we are not getting the curve, we are starting at somewhere from this point, so we have to adjust that curve as a starting point as a 0, and then we are going to take the result. So here we may observe that the dashed line that is showing that corrected results, and just a simple line that is showing is the original result of this sample. So if we are plotting this graph, depending on this graph, we have to correct all the loads corresponding to the penetration for the determination of the CBR values. So here from this graph we can say that the CBR value of 2.5 mm penetration is 4.2%. So this is the result of this graph. So we can conclude here the CBR value
of 2.5 mm penetration is more than that of the CBR value 5 mm penetration. So our result for the CBR is 4.2%. Thank you.